Hello friends, in this tutorial we are going to learn how to retarget Mixamo animations to a Daz figure imported into Unreal Engine 5. We will be using my custom IK Retargeter, so we will be able to retarget animation in a few clicks, instead of that long and boring process of manual retargeting. Just in case you are new to the topic, you may want to first watch my initial tutorial on Daz to Unreal. You can find the link in the description below this video. And now, let's get straight into it. Open Unreal Engine 5. Let's select a third-person project template. And let's name it Mixamo Anim to Daz. Hit the Create button. So, the project is loaded. Let's first name the Daz plugin. Go to Edit, Plugins, start typing Daz2 and enable the Daz to Unreal plugin. It requires restart. After restart, go to Edit, Project Settings, find the Plugin section and Daz to Unreal settings in the left column. Check the Fixed Bone Rotations and Zero Root Rotation. Now let's go to Daz 3D. I have already prepared the model. Make sure the figure is selected in the Scene tab. Go to File, Send to, Daz to Unreal. Type the asset name at the top, let's name it Daz Girl. Then check the Show FBX dialog option and hit the Accept button. In the next window, uncheck the Animations box and hit Accept. Now we go back to the Unreal Engine 5. The import is complete, just close this warning window, and we can delete this Daz Girl Anim asset. In the content drawer we navigate to Daz to Unreal, Daz Girl. We open the mesh and check if our skeleton bones are set up properly. If you have followed the first tutorial, they should actually be. Click that gear, select Show Retargeting Options, the root is set to Animation, the hit is set to Animation Scale, and all the children bones set to Skeleton. Alright, now let's go to Mixamo.com. Let's find the XBot character. At the top menu, click the Characters tab, open the XBot and download it. Let's create a folder for our Mixamo skeleton and animation. Now, at the top of Mixamo site, select the Animations tab. And let's find the animation named Roomba Dancing. Open it. You see, we can adjust the animation in various ways. But today we leave them all as they are. We will adjust the animation inside the Unreal Engine 5 after we retarget it to our Daz figure. So click the download button. From the skin drop-down menu we select without skin and hit download. Now, let's go back to the Unreal Engine 5. Open the content drawer. Under the content folder, create a new folder and name it Mixamo. And inside this new folder, let's create one more folder and name it Animation. Now, go inside the Mixamo folder. Right-click on the empty space and select the import option at the very top of the pop-up menu. Let's go to the folder we have downloaded our Mixamo stuff to and import the export FBX file. Leave none under the skeleton, but make sure to check the use T0 as ref pose. And let's import. Alright, it has been imported. Now go to the animation folder. One more time, right click, import, and import the Roomba Dancing FBX. Now make sure that the skeleton is set to Xbox skeleton. And hit the import button. Let's save everything. And now it's time to download my Mixamo to Daz IK Retargeter, which allows us to retarget animations in a few clicks. You can find the link below this video in the description. Just open the link and click the download icon at the top right and save the zip file to your hard drive. Now, unzip the file to a folder with the same name. Right-click the unzipped folder and copy it. Navigate to your Unreal project folder. In my case, it is located in My Computer, Documents, Unreal Projects. And open our current project folder named Mixamo Anim to Daz. Go to the content folder and paste the copied folder there. Alright, so now we can see this folder in our content drawer in Unreal Engine 5. And now we can retarget our Mixamo animations in just a few clicks. Let's first navigate to Daz to Unreal Daz Girl folder and create their new folder named Animations. Alright, and now navigate to Content, Mixamo, Animation. Right-click our Roomba Dancing Animation asset. Select Retarget Animation Assets, Duplicate and Retarget Animation Assets. In the IK Retargeter menu, select Mixamo IK Retargeter to Daz. and select our Daz Go skeletal mesh as a target. Let's give it a prefix Daz. And let's change the export folder to Daz to Unreal Daz Girl animation. Hit OK. And that's basically it. Let's save all. Navigate to the Daz Girl animation folder. Double click the retargeted Roomba dancing asset to edit it. It works pretty well, but like the XBot, our girl has breasts. So we see her left hand is going through her left breast. If you remember, we could actually adjust the hand's movement before downloading the animation from Mixamo. But let's do it in Unreal Engine 5. It's pretty easy. You see the hand is going through the breast somewhere around the 6th frame. So in your timeline, select the 6th frame or somewhere close to it. It actually doesn't matter so much, because once we change one frame, the Unreal Engine will interpolate or extrapolate the rest of frames in accordance with our changes. Now at the top, click Character, Bones, All Hierarchy. We can actually play with different bones, but alright, let's select this L shoulder twist bone. And let's try to twist the gizmo around the green axis until the hand is outside the breast. And as soon as it looks good, just hit the plus K button at the top. And now we play the animation and we see that everything looks fine. You can edit any animation this way, changing bones positions on different frames. And don't forget to press that plus K button once you are satisfied with the changes you made. Now we can set the bones back to invisible mode by clicking Character, Bones, None. And don't forget to save the animation after making the changes. In the next few videos, we are going to talk about some interesting things. For example, we will learn dynamic change of clothes with the Daz figure in Unreal Engine 5. I'm also going to start some basics of photorealistic cinematics. And we'll maybe start creating a basic game with some funny features. And that's it for today. Thank you for watching. Bye.